Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Shaushar Classes and Evershine Coaching Center. I am Shah Faisal sir here. My dear students, today I have come up with a new topic. Before I could start this, I wish you all the best of luck. I hope you all have done well your board exams. So I am wishing you the very best of luck for your upcoming result of Karnataka SSLC State Board 2021 results. My dear students, many students have got some sort of confusions, okay, after writing the exam. Like, sir, how the process of evaluation is done for this year and how the students are promoted for the next year. And how will be our result sheet of Karnataka SSLC 2021? And still more, much doubts our students have. So I have got a request in my YouTube channel as well through my WhatsApp and Telegram. Okay, so my dear students, now I am going to clarify your all doubts. Let's begin. Now, first point, how the process of evaluation is done for this year. My dear students, I hope you all have seen and you have already gone through that step number one. What is that? As you all knows it, every subject, it was carrying 40 questions and it has 40 marks. Am I right? And already you people have seen many YouTube channels and also many such type of videos where they have disclosed this all information. So I don't want to disclose much information related to this, how these all things will happen. Straight away I want to come to the main topic. Okay, I just don't want to waste your time in watching these concepts. Okay, so what is important and relevant to you, only those things I am going to discuss here. Every subject it was carrying 40 marks. Now, suppose out of 40 you have scored 30. So 30 out of 40, okay? It means they are going to double these marks. So 30 double is 60, 40 double is 80. It means that your total marks out of 80, it is 60 marks. Is this clear? Now, with this 60 marks, what they do, they are going to add your internal marks. Suppose you have scored 20 out of 20 in your internals. Okay, this marks is given from your school through your assignments, project work, so and so. Now you can see here 60 plus 20 is 80, 80 plus 20 is 100. Now your marks is out of 100, it is 80. Is this clear? So this is what the calculation is done to consider your final results. Now, the very important question here lies, what is that means? How the results are going to disclose? Okay, is we get the results in percentage or we get the results in, is the results are disclosed only in the marks based or so and so? Before that, I just want to tell you, only the first language, if you want, you can keep this formula. For the first mark, for the first language, the results will be disclosed like this. Marks scored, whatever the marks scored, multiplied by 2.5, you multiply that with 2.5 and add this with your internal marks. Okay, your internal assessment marks. So that is your total marks. Is this clear? For first language, marks scored multiplied by 2.5. How many marks you have scored multiplied by 2.5. Okay. How many marks scored means which marks I am discussing? I am discussing about these marks. Can you see this? Yes, these marks. Marks scored. Okay. Can you see this? These marks I am discussing. This is the marks what you have scored. Are you getting, children? So total marks scored, if you want to calculate your total marks, first what you have to do, marks code multiply by 2.5. You just multiply that with 2.5 and add with the internal marks, so that is your total marks. For an example, let me to give you one small example so that you will understand in a better way. Suppose you have scored 35, you multiply that with 2.5. Okay, then add this with your internal marks, let it be as 25. So 35 into 25, that is your 88, plus 25, that is nothing but 113. So you have scored 113 out of 125 marks. Okay, your total marks is 125, out of which you have scored 113 marks. Is this clear? Now, similarly for other subjects. For other subjects, you have to multiply this with 2. Not 2.5, you have to multiply that with 2. Is this clear? Good. Now, see children, here, if you are going to score 35 to 59 marks in this range, then you will be considered as C grade. If your score is lying between 60 to 79, then it is considered as B grade. If your score is 80 to 89, then the results are disclosed as A grade. And if your score is between 90 to 100, then your results are going to disclosed as A plus. Okay, so it is A plus. So this is what the strategy, what they are going to consider to evaluate your final result sheet. Now, see students, very important information now, which I'm going to give you here. Now, here what they do, they will give you the subject name, your marks card, how it will be. They will give you the subject name and also they will give you the marks scored from you in the external exam. And here marks scored with you, or marks scored from you in your internal marks. And also they will disclose your total marks. And then they will disclose your grade. So this will be your final marks card. Okay. The final marks card layout will be in this form. The subject name will be given. How much marks code you have scored? Out of 80. Here I am discussing about out of 80. Here I am discussing about out of 20. So how much you have scored? And this is total is 100 marks. If it is first language, then it is 125. And rest all papers is 100. And this is the grading system will be considered. Is this clear? Good. Now after this, suppose if any student, let it be, I am speaking about out of 80 marks, or let me say out of 40 marks. Okay, because you people have written the exam for 40 marks, right? Yes. So in this out of 40 marks, if any student has scored 0 marks, it means whichever the questions were given in the MCQs, like option A, B, C, D for first question, second question A, B, C, D, third question A, B, C, D, no answers are correct. I mean to say that every answer is wrong. Okay, all the answers are wrong. And my dear students, here one more important point. Okay, out of 80 marks, minimum you have to score 35 marks. If you are going to score, let me say here, in your total marks, suppose you have scored minimum how many marks? 35 marks out of 100. Okay, and here out of 80, minimum you have to score 28 marks. Out of 80, minimum your score should be 28. Out of 100, minimum your score should be 35. Okay, in this process, if you have scored below 28, previously it was considered as fail. Out of 80, if you are not scoring 28, minimum 28, then you are fail. अगर से आप 80 मार्क्स को 28 मिनिमम निकालना था, आपको मिनिमम 28 मार्क्स आना ही था, तभी आप पास हैं आउट ऑफ 80. इधर 100 में कंसीडर किए तो 35 35 रहता था. ओके, सो इफ आई थिंक दिस विल गेट कन्फ्यूज फॉर यू, लेट इट बी एक्स्ट्रा इंटरनल मार्क्स वॉट एवर यू हैव गॉट, फॉरगेट अबाउट इट. नो आई एम स्पीकिंग अबाउट ओनली दिस फॉर्मेट हियर. हाउ मच मार्क्स यू हैव टू स्कोर आउट ऑफ 80? 28 मार्क्स यू हैव टू स्कोर, देन ओनली यू आर पास. सपोज यू हैव नॉट स्कोर्ड दैट मिनिमम ऑल्सो, लाइक 28 वॉज द मिनिमम, राइट? यू हैव नॉट स्कोर्ड दैट इवन मिनिमम मार्क्स ऑफ 28. ओके, इट मीन्स 35%. इट इज नथिंग बट 35% ऑफ द टोटल मार्क्स इज योर पासिंग मार्क्स, 35%. सपोज इफ एनी स्टूडेंट हैज स्कोर्ड 0 मार्क्स, सपोज एनी स्टूडेंट हैव स्कोर्ड 10 मार्क्स, सपोज इफ एनी स्टूडेंट हैज स्कोर्ड 25 मार्क्स, लेट इट बी सपोज इफ एनी स्टूडेंट हैव स्कोर्ड 27 मार्क्स, सो देन डू यू थिंक दैट इट इज गोइंग टू बी कंसिडर्ड एज दे आर फेल? प्रीवियसली इफ दे स्कोर 28 or above 28, then only they are pass. If they were scoring below 28, then it was considered as failed. But now what in this case? If the student have scored 0 marks or 10 marks or 25 marks or 27 marks, whatever it is, I mean to say below 28, it was failed. But this year, no students, this is not considered as failed. This year, it is not considered as failed. Whatever the marks you score, they will give you minimum 28 marks. Whatever the marks you score, minimum they will give you 28 marks. Out of 100, minimum they will give you 35 marks. Okay? They will give you minimum 35 marks. So, if you have scored 0, then 28 marks is the grace marks. They will put in your marks card as 28 and they will give you the result as your C grade. Remember this, if you have scored 0 also, they will award you as 28 only. If you have scored 10 marks also, they will give you the result as, if you have scored 10 also, in the result sheet, it will be 28 only. Or if you take 35 marks, 35% of out of 100, then they will give you 35 only. If you have scored 25 also, out of 100, they will give you 35 only. Are you getting my point? It means this year, the Karnataka SSLC board is not going to fail any student. Karnataka SSLC board is not going to fail any student this year. Is this clear? If you have scored 33 also, they will change it to 35. If you score 0 also, they will change that as 35. If you score less than 35 any marks, the rest of the marks they will give you as grace marks and they will push you for 35. And they will declare your result as you are passed, and the result sheet they will declare as C grade. Okay, the result sheet will be declared as you are under C grade, but you are passed. Any doubts? Is this clear? I hope you all are understanding. Yes. So I just want to give you one more confirmation, because I hope after this, may watching this video, many students may come with this doubt. Remember students, if any student are scoring 35 to 59 marks, they are going to be considered as C grade. And also if any student have scored 0 marks also, if any student has scored 0 or less than 35, for that student also they will give the marks as 35. And they will say that student has got promoted for next year. That student has promoted. If student has taken 10 marks also, the rest of the marks to reach 35, they will give that as grace marks. And they are pushing him to score as 35. And that student has got promoted for the next year. So this year, none of the students are going to get failed. All the students are going to get passed with minimum passing marks. But for the rest of the students who have scored 50, 60, 80, 90, for those students, there is no grace marks. How much marks you have scored, that is your final marks. No marks are going to be considered as grace marks for those students. Only for the students who have failed in the exam, who are about to fail, okay? Only for such type of students, they are giving as grace marks just to reach as minimum passing marks, and they are going to clear those students also. And this is applicable for fresher students and also for repeaters and also for the private students. So this system is applicable for each and every student who all have written this year SSLC final board exam for the academic year 2021. Is this clear? I hope the concepts are clear. How will be the marks card layout and what is the strategy they are going to apply to clear this year final SSLC board exam. I hope the concepts are clear for you all. Wish you all the best of luck, my dear students. Keep watching to our YouTube channel, and still if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, Shasar Classes, do subscribe it and click the bell icon and share this video as much as possible with your all friends and also with your classmates. Still if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, Shasar Classes, kindly do subscribe it. Our YouTube channel name is Shasar Classes. Do subscribe to this YouTube channel and share this channel as much as possible. And my dear students, also we have many programs in future which we are going to adopt in our YouTube channel, so that we are going to conduct classes even for PUC also in the same way. And the admissions are open for this year batch, okay, for the Karnataka SSLC board, CBSE, and also for the ICSE board students. Online or offline classes are available. If you want still more details, in the below description I have given the contact details. You can contact to me and you can share your views with us through the comment section. Thank you. Take care. Once again, wish you all the best of luck for your future and for as well for your upcoming results. Thank you. Take care. Bye bye.